Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here. Friends, we are continuing with our coverage of BNABs, and today we are going to talk about 10E8LVS. So 10E8 stands for the original BNAB, LS stands for long lasting, and V probably seems to be a variant or something like that. So that's my understanding. And this BNAB acts on what is called as the MPER region of HIV. And we'll start this video by understanding the role of MPER, and then we'll end up with understanding what happened to this BNAB, where is it at this point of time in terms of its research and availability to the patients. So with that said, let's get started. Welcome back, friends. Let me start by describing the MPER and its role in propagating HIV. The membrane proximal external region, or MPER, is a highly conserved segment of HIV-1 GP41 enveloped glycoprotein located near the viral membrane. This region plays a crucial role in the virus's ability to fuse with the host cells, a necessary step for HIV to infect these cells. And if you want to understand how MPER helps aid HIV, I would explain by saying that MPER is crucial or critical for the fusion process between the viral envelope and the host cell membrane. This fusion allows the viral RNA to enter the host cell and initiate infection. MPER interacts with the host cell membrane and other parts of GP41 to bring the viral and cellular membranes into close proximity, facilitating their merger. And MPER is part of the GP41 protein, which undergoes significant conformational changes during the fusion process. These changes are essential for the virus to successfully fuse with the host cell membrane and are mediated by the MPER region. Due to its critical role in membrane fusion, MPER is highly conserved among different strains of HIV, because if this region gets mutated, then it will not be able to make copies of itself and it will become extinct. Only those copies of HIV which have this MPER region intact will be able to propagate themselves. So that's why this is a highly conserved region. And this makes it an attractive target for BNABs, or broadly neutralizing antibodies, as these antibodies can target a wide range of HIV variants. Despite its importance, MPER is also involved in helping the virus evade the immune system in a way, because it is partially hidden in the viral envelope structure, making it less accessible to host antibodies. This characteristic allows the virus to evade immune detection to some extent. And because of its critical role and conserved nature, MPER is a target for vaccine development and therapeutic antibodies like 10E8VLS. These BNABs aim to neutralize the virus by binding to MPER, blocking the fusion process and preventing the virus from infecting host cells. 10E8VLS is a BNAB developed for the treatment and prevention of HIV-1. It targets the highly conserved MPER region of HIV-1 viral envelope glycoprotein. The antibody is an enhanced version of the original 10E8, designed to improve solubility, stability, and efficacy. A phase 1 clinical trial evaluated the safety and pharmacokinetics of 10E8VLS administered subcutaneously to healthy non-HIV infected individuals. The study involved two groups, one receiving 10E8VLS alone and another receiving it in combination with another BNAB, which was VRC07523LS. The trial revealed that while 10E8VLS retained its neutralizing capacity and no anti-drug antibodies were detected, it caused unexpected local reactogenicity and also symptoms such as erythema and induration at the injection site. This reaction led to the early termination of the trial with an aim to modify the BNAB so that these problems can be overcome. Now let me explain the term retrogenicity. Sorry. Now let me explain the term reactogenicity. It refers to the property of a vaccine or other biological product to produce common expected adverse reactions, particularly those related to the activation of the immune system. In the context of 10E8VLS clinical trial, Local reactogenicity refers to reaction at the site of the injection. Erythema is a condition characterized by redness of the skin. It occurs due to the dilation of capillaries and increased blood flow to the area, often as a result of inflammation. In the context of an injection site reaction, erythema is usually a sign of the body's immune response to the injected substance. The hardening or firming of the tissue at the injection site is referred to as induration. It often results from the inflammation or the accumulation of immune cells responding to the injected substance. Indurations can be felt as a firm, raised area on the skin. These conditions are common indicators of an immune response to an injected substance, but can vary in severity. In the case of the 10E8VLS trial, these local reactions were more severe than expected, with some participants experiencing significant discomfort and inflammation at the injection site. This prompted the early termination of the trial to ensure participant safety and also to commence modifications to the BNAB to remove these defects. The findings suggest that further modification and studies are needed to mitigate these side effects and enhance the antibody's efficacy for future use in HIV-1 immunoprophylaxis and treatment. So friends, that is the story of the new BNAB that we spoke about today, which is 10E8VLS. Now, I think some of you might be a bit disappointed that this did not work out, and you may be wondering, Raj, why did you waste a video discussing this? But I'm thinking in my books that this is not a done deal. There could be modifications done to this BNAB in order to perform a very vital role, because on one end, you could have an antibody that can latch onto the CCR5 and protect the CD4 T cell indiscriminately, but we don't know what it would do to the rest of the body if healthy CD4 T cells had their CCR5 muted. And on the other hand, if we were to remove the CCR5 from select CD4 T cells and put it into the body like AGT-103-T is trying to do, it can give a certain amount of relief. Now, what is being attempted with this BNAB right now is to make sure that it latches onto the part of the HIV which enables it to fuse with CCR5 and then make a conformational change and induce the RNA of the HIV virus to get into the CD4. So that is the approach being done. I think that's a very viable approach because it will come in between HIV and the CCR5 of any given CD4 T cell that the virus chooses to infect. And that will prevent it from delivering the viral payload into the CD4 T cell. So this is a very, very important strategy, and efforts have to be made to modify the BNAB so that this strategy can be achieved. And I think that in combination with other BNABs will be a very, very strong cocktail that can act not only as a prophylaxis, but also it could help reduce viral load within the body, in my personal opinion. And friends, there has been some misconception. There was somebody on the channel who was writing that this guy is not a doctor and it's all fake. So I would say that anything that you see on internet, you have to take it with a pinch of salt, including my own videos. And I have never claimed to be a doctor or a scientist. Everything I'm doing is a voluntary effort to provide information to PLHIV so that you can get latest information. I'm reading the leading sources like NIH or the FDA's publications or Nature magazine and the company sources in order to get my information. So it's absolutely your choice what you want to do with my video. The only thing I would request is that if you are disappointed and if you feel that the world has cheated you, that you have HIV and there is no cure coming up despite decades of research, I would suggest that you try to contain the disappointment, try to go to a counselor and try to see if they can help you manage your expectations and help you improve your mood and help you to enjoy life. Putting any negative comment here is counterproductive because there are a lot of people living with HIV who come here to get a kind of motivation. Many people find motivation because they can see that scientists are doing research and a lot of different antibodies and different therapies are being tested. So those people are coming here for motivation, and negative comments in this channel tends to make them unhappy. And my whole mission is to give you motivation, and my effort also gets negated by such comments. So once again, let me tell you very clearly, I'm not a doctor and I'm not a scientist. And if you do not find my videos credible, please do not watch the videos, but please do not demotivate the people who believe in the channel and who believe in the information that I'm giving them. So with that said, my friends, I would like to bring this video to an end. And I'd also like to make a request to you. If you like my videos, I've got hundreds of videos on HIV in this channel. I would just request you to forward this video or this channel to a friend of yours who can be helped by the contents out here, and request them to subscribe so that we can grow the channel and reach more people. Thanks and have a great day, and bye for now.